My name is Elizabeth Russell, and I just opened the Bay State Paranormal Center on November 1st. And what the Paranormal Center does is it offers all things paranormal. It's primarily a learning facility. We have a very large catalog of classes that we offer and will continue to offer. Anything from Wicca sciences to werewolves.
Really?
And so anything in between, UFOs, cryptozoology, ghosts, anything pretty much that you can think of. If we don't have it, I will find it for you. We also offer public investigations. We do private investigations. We are forming our own paranormal investigative team, and we hope to begin doing investigations in December.
You have one scheduled for the USS Salem, is that correct?
Yes, we have our first public investigation is the USS Salem, which is located in Quincy. It was built as a battleship, however, it was never used as such since it was launched just after the end of World War II. So it ended up being an ambassador kind of diplomatic ship, and serving countries that were in need.
Now, if I could just backtrack a little bit and have you tell me a little bit how you got started in investigating the paranormal.
Well, I didn't start investigating till recently. I always had an interest in the paranormal, but I was always really scared of it. I wanted to talk about it, but I was too scared to talk about it because I felt like, I'd get possessed or, something terrible would happen, and then I'd go insane and my life would never be the same. So I would listen, to stories, and I'd almost have tears in my eyes, but then I'd, kind of back away. I'd see scary movies on the topic, and then I'd have to sleep with the lights on. And then one night, I came across this television show, and there were these two guys investigating the paranormal. They were looking for ghosts.
Are we talking about Ghost Hunters Society?
We sure are.
Okay,
we sure are.
Cool.
And as strange as it sounds, it never occurred to me to investigate with scientific equipment. It never occurred to me to go looking for ghosts. And the crazy thing is I'm an educated scientist. I'm a trained scientist. I know how to use the tool.
Great. Oh, my goodness.
But it never occurred to me to apply that to the paranormal. And I started watching the show, and I was like, geez, they're not afraid. They're out there. Nothing's happening to them, and it's all scientific. So if they can do it, I think I can do it. But I really did kind of sit on the sidelines for quite a while. When I started watching the show, I was actually living in a haunted house, and I was having the first real experiences of my life. Prior to that, if someone told me a story, I was like, fine, you believe it. I believe that you believe it, but I don't know that it's true.
Okay, now you can't gloss over the fact you're living in a haunted house.
Oh, I'm going back to that.
Okay.
No, there's no glossing over that.
Okay.
So, I believe that they believed it was true, but then, I moved into this gorgeous 22-room Victorian mansion, very prominent home in Taunton, and within 6 months, things started happening. I had these snowmen figurines, three separate snowman figurines, and I was just a little bit too anal about having their noses pointing in the same direction. And I kept coming back to them and finding the noses realigned, pointing in another direction. And it wasn't like they were askew. They were all pointing exactly in another direction. And this kept happening over and over again. It took me a while to figure out, oh my God, I think something's happening. And I was like, first just annoyed with it. It was just strange, And then I mentioned something to my landlady, and she's like, there's no way. If there was a ghost here, I'd know it. I lived with Captain Ferguson for 20 years in Dartmouth. There's no ghost. And I was like, okay. But, my clock arched and flew off the wall. It went against gravity.
You were actually standing there and you saw that?
I saw that. The first time it happened, I didn't see it. And I thought it was really strange that it fell so far away from the wall. But the second time, actually, I saw it and my cat saw it. He's not telling anybody about it.
So,
but, the clock was just really freaky. You know, I had set it 1 year. After it fell off the wall for the second time, I put it back on and I never touched it again. And then 1 year, I was like, fine, I'll reset it for daylight savings. So I set it, and then I come back a little while later, and it's 2 hours behind what I actually set it. And I'm like, I am never touching that clock again. I tried to sell it at a yard sale, and no one would buy it. I didn't tell them it was haunted. But, you know, hearing footsteps above me, although there was an apartment above me, there was a period of like 3 months when no one lived there. And it was like a party was going on all the time. You know, there was footsteps, running, things being dropped on the floor. It was really crazy. And it was pretty consistent, too. Usually around Saturday night, around 9 o'clock, it usually would break out in a bunch of noise. But then there was a set of stairs that had been in one location in the house.